Oh shit, we're on Detour. We're on Detour, the Vengeance DLC, aka Crappy McCrapstain DLC. What is going on though? Mark's been here, guys, and we have some Search and Destroy swarms for today. Well, a swarm, I should say. Just a 20-in-1 here on Detour. And I had a few things to talk about. First, in the beginning of the video, I wanted to mention the trick shot or trolling. I don't do those all the time, and I'm sorry because I know you guys like to watch them and they're kind of funny. But in my version of trolling, I don't really troll so much as that I'm just playing the game and people yell at me, which is kind of funny. So I can't really make it happen. I don't like go around and purposely try to annoy people because I have better things to do with my life. So it's not my style. So I don't post those as often as I know you guys would like because you do get a laugh out of them. But I'm not getting rid of the series. I just have to take time to record and save clips and things like that because I can only put together so many. I don't want to post like, you know, a 30-second video of like one lobby getting mad at me just momentarily. I'd rather make, you know, a 4-minute video or 5-minute video of it. So just keep that in mind. That's not the topic for today, but I wanted to mention it. So Halloween, or Beggar's Night, I guess I should say tonight, where you go out and get candy for free, apparently. It doesn't work for me. I'm pretty sure when you're 23 and you walk around, you look for candy, people think you're kind of a pedophile. But it is for younger kids. You, even if like 13 or 14, you can still dress up, I'm sure. You guys have wonderful outfits, of course, ninjas and Power Rangers. That's what I always was. I was always a ninja and Power Ranger. Actually, a few years ago when I was like 18 or 19, I did the comedian from The Watchmen, and I just walked around smoking a cigar. So I was of age, you know, I'm 19, 18, whatever. That's legal age to smoke, and it was just a fun little get up to do. The comedian was pretty cool. I should have killed that guy. I'm choked so hard on that kill right there. I'm sorry. Anyway, yeah, it wasn't the topic either, but I brought it up anyway. I'm sorry. Let's talk about something that is pretty common in all the Call of Duties, DLC. Since we're on Detour here, I'd like to mention that the DLC in Black Ops 2, and I don't know if you guys feel the same or not, it's pretty awful, really, in my opinion. And for Search, of course, you, as a Respawn player, you might enjoy some of these maps more than I will. But for Search, I would say one out of every four maps they release is decent, which is, okay, cool, they got one map, but let's be honest, 75% failure rate isn't pretty good. That's, I mean, you're paying $20 or $15 for 75%, I'm sorry, shit content. The maps are awful. This map is not good for Search. I got a lucky game on it. That's what happens once in a while. You play it enough, you get lucky. But it's not good for Search. Again, the map Cove is not good for Search, okay? Cove isn't good. Rush is okay, but it's not even good anyway, because there's no flanking on Rush, really. You have to run into him, outgun him, and then you can flank. But that's not good. I think that more often than not, the maps that they come out with DLC is pretty bad. And you guys can say yes or no as well. It's totally up to you. It's an opinion, of course. And I bring this up because Advanced Warfare is coming out shortly. And I don't know if I want to buy the DLC in the game. I mean, I usually get the Season Pass. I got the Season Pass, I think, on Ghosts. I don't know. Actually, maybe did I? I don't know if I did. I think I didn't actually get that one because I got so sick of it so quick that I didn't buy the DLC Pass. Or the Season... Sorry, the DLC Season Pass. I did have it on Black Ops 2. And I have all the maps downloaded and everything. But, you know, after playing them, I regret it. It's like, fuck, these maps blow. And I can't remember in other games where I really thought the DLC was awful. MW3, the DLC wasn't too bad, but I was never good at it because I didn't play it that much. MW2, I didn't play the DLC at all, actually. I didn't buy any DLC, but I thought MW2 was my favorite Call of Duty. I had no problems with it. I loved the game. And a lot of people actually like the DLC in MW2. I kind of suck at it because I just don't have the experience playing it. I don't really know how people play the DLC because I never played it in its prime. So I don't understand where people go on in certain routes and things like that. But I'm sure I could learn it if I played it a lot, you know, a lot more and kind of got used to it. But in Advanced Warfare, will the DLC be the same? I mean, will the maps be awful for the most part for Search, or will they be really well, like really well balanced for spawn points and bomb spots? I think any map, really, any map that these guys design could be okay for Search and Destroy, but I feel like they place the bombs at very crap locations, and that's what causes the problems. Like, any of these maps they design, of course some maps could be improved by map design, but they could be improved simply by moving bombs to certain spots and making it more even for offense defense. That really could solve a lot of the problems. And unfortunately, they don't do that. And I don't think they've ever done that, moved a bomb. But It might be a lot to ask, I guess. I do think that could solve a lot of issues, though. And like I said, it's totally an opinion. You guys could be up for it or down for it, whatever. You'd be like, yeah, that would work. Or no, Marksman, I think you're crazy. These maps just suck all around. Or maybe they're good to you and you just think I'm nuts. But Detour, for example, defense basically has B control. And they have the close offense spawn, so it makes it really hard. Plus a lot of head glitches. I think this map would have been much better balanced if A-bomb was just a little bit further to the offense side and maybe more in the middle of the map. Yeah, it makes it really hard to plant when it's in the middle, but it's much easier than planting on A now. And B is basically impossible, let's be honest. You have to walk down a slim tunnel against a team that's already waiting there with rifles if they wanted to camp out, and a lot of people do in search. There's no chance you're going to make that. Like, look at this right here on the route I'm taking. I switch to a rifle, I can sit on the head glitch, and you can never push me. I mean, you can't run around. I'll outgun you. I'm on a head glitch waiting for you. My teammate dies because he pushes up and he's crazy, but if you just wanted to chill there, it's problem solved. You can't really go anywhere. The dude tries to get me, can't even do it. So I think that, you know, bomb placements really make maps good and bad, and I think that they should allow it to be changed, in my opinion. If that's something they can do within the game, that would be a huge benefit, because any map could be good as long as the bombs can be moved. So, just my opinion, though. I'm hoping the DLC for Advanced Warfare will be hot, but we'll have to wait and see. The game itself seems really campy, and I don't know how well the DLC will play out on it. But hope you guys enjoyed. Comment, rate, subscribe, and I'll talk to y'all later.